here I am at Artists and Craftsmen Supply. This is one of the best stores. It's like a big warehouse of art supplies. So I'm here with my assistant, Ellie, and she's helping me videograph. And it's kind of cool, because look over that way. Look at that neat design that's on the building. All right, now we're gonna go in and we're going to explore what to get for sketch materials. Okay, let's go in. So here we have a number of sketchbooks and we're going to check them out. Now, one thing I like to look for when I'm doing a sketchbook depends on whether I'm using graphite, charcoal, or pen and ink. Let's look at this one right here. This is a mixed media textbook and it's got pretty good tooth. You just have to feel it and listen. You can hear it's got a little texture. So that means it's going to hold your graphite and your charcoal. But remember, graphite and charcoal can kind of smudge inside a sketchbook. So a couple things you want to consider, I'm going this way, is what kind of sketchbook you want the binding to be. This type of binding is nice, but you can't really hold it open flat. So that's a consideration. The other one is the spiral binding. This can open flat and you can fold it back. It's great for standing out and sketching. This has a nice tooth. I like that one. So these could be very good sketchbooks, but you're not going to be able to check this in the store because it's covered with plastic. So you need to have a friend or someone that has experience to check and find out whether that's a good paper or not. Or you just take a chance and buy it and see what happens. Here is some Strathmore. I like Strathmore. As I said, my favorite is a watercolor Strathmore sketchbook. This is nice. It folds back with the spiral binding. Has a pretty good tooth on it. And then there's this sketchbook, which has a smooth tooth. So this would be good for graphite pencils or your pen and ink. So just go through, check them out, make sure your hands are clean. You don't want to ruin the product in the store, and give it a quick check. Well, that's some ideas on sketchbooks. Assistant Ellie just noticed this sketchbook right here. This is Aqua, so it's basically designed for watercolor, but you can also use it for pen and ink washes. So it's interesting because you can open it up and it has a nice long format. I like unusual formats rather than the standard ones, and it's thick enough so it can hold your fluids and it's not going to wrinkle the paper. So this is a great one. And look, a little elastic to hold it all together. Okay, now follow me over to the tools over this way. It's quite a walk. We have a variety of graphite pencils here. There's so many to choose from. You can use a regular 2H, but you're not going to get a nice dark with a 2H. It's just going to come a kind of a light, shiny gray. And that's the thing with graphite. It kind of gets shiny after a while, as opposed to charcoal that's nice and soft. So this is graphite. They come in different hardnesses. So you go from HB in the middle, which is the neutral one. If you go towards the Bs, 2, 4, 6, 8, it gets softer as it goes out. If you go toward the Hs, 2, 4, 6, 8, it gets harder. So that's going to be lighter marks. Another thing that is fun to have is this is just graphite, which means basically there's no wood here. It's a lot easier to sharpen and get a point without breaking the wood, because sometimes the graphite is more breakable than the wood when you're sharpening it. Or you can get wide graphite sticks as well. If you want to cover a large area, you can just lay this right on its side and get a nice large area of graphite. If you decide to use charcoal because of the controllability of charcoal, this is some of the tools I use. I like using a nice fine charcoal. It's soft, it blends easily, and if you want to remove it, sometimes just a wipe of the hand will do it, or it erases very well. There's also, it comes in different thicknesses, and then you have your charcoal pencils. So these are great to do to get details. Nice item to have. This is one of my favorite sketch tools, as I said in one of my other videos. These Technopens right here by Pastel are great. You can get them in a whole set, like this, different style, different size points, or you can buy them individually. Now, I happen to like the number 3 and the number 8, and I can get a lot done with these two pens. I'll put a colored tape around one of them so I can tell the difference quickly when I'm out sketching. Another thing they have is a water brush. I'm sorry, this is an ink brush, and you can just use this for drawing, so that's pretty cool too. And yeah, there you go. These come ink-filled brushes. Just another option. What can I say? I found the water brushes. Here they are. These are pretty great. You can buy them in a set, which is nice. Then you have a bunch of them just in case, or you can buy them individually. Now this just holds water in the bottom part. And then with those pastel pens that I just showed you, when the ink is still wet, you just take and barely touch this and it acts like a watercolor and it bleeds that ink out to give you a nice gray value. And you can control it, it makes something really interesting, and then it dries totally flat and it doesn't smudge in your sketchbook. If you're just starting out, this might be something you want to try, but I will tell you, in my opinion, it's better to buy the quality materials and buy fewer because they're going to last longer. I don't know how color fast this is, but for a kid or something, just figuring out what they might want to do in art, this could be a good thing. Here is your classic pastel paper. This is what I used for years, not knowing until recently, just maybe 5 years ago, about sanded papers, which are life-changing. But the Mi-Tint by Canson is a great way to go. When you're using this, kind of be aware of the different textures of both sides. One kind of has a mechanical grid on it. You can't see it here, but it is there. So I always use the side that didn't have that mechanical press on it. I liked that better. Comes in all sorts of colors, and you can use the color as an integral part of your artwork. All right, if you want to get experimental with your pastels, it's a great way of doing that. You can start with a Mi-Tint paper, tape it down, and you can take something like a fine pumice gel and just put a thin glaze of that over your paper, and ta-da, you've got sanded pastel paper. It's wonderful. And if you want color underneath that, you can add one of your golden acrylic paints in a very thin wash, and it will tone your paper, so you're starting with toned paper. This is a sanded paper here. This is your ColorFix Art Spectrum. It has a light tooth of sand, and it comes in different colors. Pretty cool. Look at that fingernail. And it holds the pastel, which is really nice. This one is a Sennelier. They're quite expensive. But when you're doing high quality paintings, you want the best products. Trick with these two is that they do not take liquids. So if you decide to use any alcohol or water in your pastel painting, which you can do, you don't want these papers. You want something that takes fluids. Okay. Now, when you're starting out with pastels, it's great to get a small set. Sometimes it's good, it gets you going and you try different things. And then once you really get into it, you're gonna choose certain colors. Now if you look over here, come right over, nice and close, you get all of these different colors. And they're soft. These are Rembrandts, they're medium soft. They're great for underpainting. When you get into your, this is oil pastel, be careful. You always wanna check whether it's a soft pastel or oil pastel. These are soft pastels. So this is almost pure pigment, as you can see, with very little binder. And the binder is a natural binder. So it's nothing toxic in there. You do have to kind of be careful if they're pure pigment, but that's about it. Schmincke are a great brand, just one of the tops of the world. This is oil pastel, totally different animal. It's more to me, I explain it as like a fancy crayon. But it has oil in it, so it acts totally different and does not mix with your soft pastels. Here we have our new pastels, Prismacolor new pastels. This is used a lot for underpainting. Recently, the company has switched and it's being manufactured in another place, and they put this paper on it. They are also beginning to discontinue the individual sticks, so if you want some, in a situation like this, this is where you grab them. Over here, we have sennelier. Sennelier is from Paris, France. Again, here's your oil pastel, if you want to use those. But I am into the extra soft pastels. These are just like butter, colored butter, but it's not oily. It's like soft and just delicious. And down here, oh, look at these. They have some of your sparkly ones, your luminescent ones. So that's fun too. That's the color I want. That's the color I want right there. Look at that. That nice sage green. Sweet. Well, that's a quick intro to your pastel sticks. Another option for pastels is the pan pastel. This is a great little item. It's a pastel, but it's in a little tube, and there's a number of them here. Not in a tube, it's in a cake, almost like makeup. And you just take these special sponges and take it across the top and then put that onto your paper. It is wonderful for underpainting and for soft, hazy effects. And this is my favorite sponge right here, but they come in all sorts of sizes. Here we have ground pigment. This is pure pigment ground into a powder. And you can take this, and by adding a little gum tragacanth, you can make your own pastels. I have another YouTube video about doing that, and if you have any questions, let me know. If you get oil on something, you want Dawn, right, to get the oil out. If you get something organic into clothing or other materials, you want an OxyClean type product that has the enzymes to eat up that organic material. But if you get pigment in something, there's basically only one thing that I have really found that gets that out. If you find something else, let me know. This right here, they're out of it, it's so popular, but this is the brush cleaner. This is a great little product. You wet it, you get a scrubby brush, you get this on here and scrub it, and it works. Look, they've got a giant tub of it right here. I think I want one of these. Best product.
These are called Poscas, and they're markers that also have paint, and they have a bunch of different sizes. Like, these are super small, and then they get bigger. And then these are very big, and they have a bunch of different colors. And over here, you can do so much more things. Like this says, you can use them on different surfaces, and you can use them on rocks, you can use them on metal. So yeah.